All FDA-approved biological products, including biosimilars and interchangeable biosimilars, undergo a rigorous evaluation to help ensure their safety, purity, and potency, also known as safety and efficacy. There are different approval pathways for biologics under the Public Health Service Act. FDA licenses or approves biological reference products, often called originator products, under Section 351A of the Public Health Service Act, and biosimilar and interchangeable biosimilar products under Section 351K, which was added by the Biologics Price Competition and Innovation Act of 2009. For a biological product submitted under the 351A pathway, manufacturers include all information and data necessary to establish its safety and effectiveness for each indication in the product application. In contrast, the goal of the 351K application biosimilar pathway is to demonstrate that a proposed biosimilar is highly similar to and has no clinically meaningful differences from its reference product. The biosimilar pathway generally avoids the need to conduct as many costly and lengthy clinical studies. When FDA makes a regulatory decision about whether a proposed product is biosimilar to its reference product, it doesn't look at just one piece of evidence or study to make its determination. Instead, FDA evaluates the totality of evidence presented by a manufacturer to demonstrate that a biosimilar is highly similar to and has no clinically meaningful differences from the reference product. What evidence does FDA consider when it makes this determination? Using the totality of the evidence approach, FDA considers data and information submitted in an application, such as structural and functional characterization and clinical data, to determine whether they demonstrate that the proposed biosimilar meets the approved standard. An approved biosimilar is as safe and effective as the reference product. FDA examines data generated from numerous scientific studies using state-of-the-art technologies to compare, among other things, the mechanism of action, structure, and function, and other molecular properties of the proposed biosimilar and its reference product. Biosimilar manufacturers submit a comprehensive package of study details and results to FDA for review. FDA considers all of these data and information to assess the extensive comparisons between analytical, pharmacologic, immunologic, and additional clinical data as needed to demonstrate that a proposed product meets the standards for biosimilarity. FDA looks at multiple types of information in the package of study details and results. For example, in the comparative analytical assessment, there are many molecular properties or attributes of a product that can be analytically compared. FDA pays particularly close attention to a critical group of them. Research and previous tests have shown that certain properties are especially important aspects of the reference product's safety and efficacy. FDA reviews data on these properties, measured using multiple techniques, to determine if differences exist. FDA also reviews an assessment of toxicity. In addition, FDA looks at clinical study data, including pharmacokinetic and pharmacodynamic, or PK/PD profiles, to determine whether the product demonstrates it is safe and effective in at least one condition of use. Manufacturers may also submit immunogenicity data that compare the incidence and severity of immune responses in the body, if needed. In some cases, additional data may be necessary to inform whether the proposed product is biosimilar to the reference product. Product-specific considerations, like whether it is a topical product with limited systemic absorption, may determine the type of additional information that may be requested. If additional studies are needed to better characterize the product or inform whether observed differences may be clinically meaningful, the application is not approved, and the manufacturer is asked to complete additional testing, such as additional clinical studies, to address the deficiencies before they can resubmit the application to the FDA. FDA reviews the new data provided by the manufacturer to determine if it provides the information needed to meet the standards for approval. If so, adding this information to the existing totality of the evidence supports a determination that the proposed product is highly similar to and has no clinically meaningful differences compared to the reference product, and, therefore, the product is biosimilar. As for all biological products, FDA also conducts facility inspections and evaluates manufacturing data to ensure that approved biosimilar products and manufacturing processes meet rigorous quality standards. Rather than relying on a single type of evidence, FDA considers all the available data and information to determine whether the evidence supports biosimilarity. The totality of the evidence approach allows FDA to evaluate each proposed biosimilar individually and advise manufacturers on the scope and extent of testing needed to come to a regulatory decision on that particular biosimilar product. This is to help ensure all biosimilars meet the FDA's rigorous approval standards so that patients and healthcare providers can be confident in the safety and effectiveness of the biosimilar, just as they are for the reference product.